by Rudyard Kipling, music composed by the Doors. Once upon a time, on an uninhabited island on the shores of the Red Sea, there lived a Parsi from whose hat the rays of the sun were reflected in more than oriental splendor.
Thank you.
which, as you have not heard, I will now proceed to relate. Then the cakes which the Parsi man bakes makes dreadful mistakes. And there was a great deal more than that than you would think, because 5 weeks later, there was a heat wave in the Red Sea. And everybody took off all the clothes that they had. The Parsi took off his hat, the rhinoceros took off his skin, and carried it over his shoulder as he came down to the beach to bathe. In those days, it buttoned underneath with 3 buttons. Like a waterproof. He said nothing whatever about the Parsi's cake because he had eaten all of it and he never had any manners then, since, or henceforward. He waddled straight into the water and blew bubbles through his nose. And leaving the skin on the beach. Presently, the Parsi came by and found the skin, and he smiled one smile that ran all down his face 2 times. Then he danced 3 times around the skin and rubbed his hands. Then he went to his cap and filled his hat with cake crumbs. For the Parsi never ate anything but cake and never swept out his cap. He took that skin and he shook that skin and he scrubbed that skin and he rubbed that skin as full of old, dry, tickly cake crumbs and some burnt currants as he could ever possibly hold. Then he climbed to the top of his palm tree. And he waited for the rhinoceros to come out of the water and put it on. And the rhinoceros did. He buttoned it up with the 3 buttons. And it tickled like cake crumbs in bed. And then he wanted to scratch. But that made it worse. And then he lay down on the sand and he rolled and he rolled and he rolled. And every time he rolled, the cake crumbs tickled him worse and worse and worse. Then he ran to the palm tree and rubbed and rubbed himself against it. He rubbed so much and so hard that he rubbed his skin into a great fold over his shoulders and another fold underneath, where the buttons used to be. But he rubbed the buttons clean off. He rubbed some more folds under his legs, and it spoiled his temper, but it didn't make the least bit of difference to the cake crumbs. They were inside his skin, and they tickled. So he went home, very angry indeed, and horribly scratchy. And from that day to this, every rhinoceros has great folds in his skin and a very bad temper, all on account of the cake crumbs inside. And the Parsi came down from his palm tree.
mat, from which the rays of the sun were reflected in more than oriental splendor. Packed up his cooking stove and went away in the direction of Orotavo, Amygdala, the upland meadows of Anantarivo, and the marshes of Sonoput.